Item number, SCP-305. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-305 is presently immobile. Site-305 has been constructed around its present location, a wooded canyon near, and is staffed by at least 7 personnel who have prior experience with SCP-305 and proved resistant to its effects. The remainder of the station crew should be rotated on a weekly basis. SCP-305's effect grows weaker if human subjects are exposed to it for extended periods of time. Therefore, a resistant subject should be exposed to it for at least 3 hours daily. SCP-305's effects are greatly magnified in individuals with feelings of guilt, particularly over crimes or mental instability. Therefore, Site-305 is staffed exclusively by non-D-class researchers and agents who are screened for criminal records and mental instability. Any personnel who begin to hear whispered compliments must be transferred out immediately. If symptoms persist after removal, frontal lobotomy, data expunged. The actual containment chamber of SCP-305 is constructed of standard materials and offset from the rest of the station by a 5-meter buffer zone to protect normal staff from the worst of SCP-305's effects. Site-305 broadcasts a constant status normal signal to Site-19. If Site-305 becomes compromised during a containment breach, this signal will cease, and a heavily armed containment team will immediately be dispatched to the location. Instances of SCP-305-1 are extremely dangerous and should be terminated on site without attempting containment. As of 2000, all attempts to extract samples from SCP-305 for study are forbidden. Description: SCP-305 is a rock formation of approximately humanoid size and shape. Remote recordings of SCP-305 show that it remains stationary at all times, even when interacting with human subjects. When viewed by a sentient observer, SCP-305 appears to be a mobile, animate humanoid of indeterminate sex. This manifestation is formed of cracked rock, similar to SCP-305's physical form, and while it is faceless, subjects report that the cracks all over SCP-305's surface begin to resemble human lips and ears as it moves. Human subjects who make visual contact with this manifestation hear whispering voices, although recording equipment in the area picks up nothing, and the phenomenon is observed even in subjects who are deaf from birth. SCP-305 will initially ingratiate itself with the subject by whispering compliments. During this phase, the subject experiences feelings of friendliness and trust towards SCP-305. These sensations seem unrelated to the actual content of the compliments, which ranges from off to nonsensical and disturbing. A short list of reported compliments is included. You have beautiful eye sockets. Every one of your fingers. Your neck appears unusually flexible. In the second phase, the subject begins to hear many voices emanating from SCP-305. At this point, the whispers become critical, attempting to insult the subject or undermine the subject's self-esteem, especially by playing on the subject's guilty conscience. Like the compliments, these insults make little sense when recounted, but have a profound psychological effect, driving the subject to suicide before the final phase in 20% of cases. If the subject is removed from SCP-305's presence during Phase 2, the subject will hallucinate that these insults are emanating from mouth-like cracks that appear to form on the ground, walls, and ceiling. In the third and final phase, the voices will abruptly stop. 2 to 10 hours from the cessation of hallucinations, SCP-305's humanoid manifestation will appear and kill the subject. Causes of death are varied, but include severe cardiac infarct, muscle spasm leading to severing of the spinal column, diaphragm paralysis, and a subject who dies of any cause after the beginning of the second phase, data expunged, followed by the emergence of an instance of SCP-3051 from the corpse. SCP-3051 are humanoids, slightly smaller than SCP-305 itself. Unlike SCP-305, SCP-3051 seem to be made of a smooth, hard white substance, and the lips and mouths on their surfaces are extremely lifelike. SCP-3051 have the same abilities as SCP-305, and although they are created with a very short range of 2 meters, this range increases exponentially over time. SCP-3051 move at 30 kilometers an hour, and seem naturally drawn in a direct line towards the nearest densely populated area, presumably in an attempt to further propagate themselves. SCP-3051 are highly resistant to bullets and cutting weapons. Elimination teams should be equipped with heavy ballistics and explosives. In subjects who have entered Stage 2, manifestation of SCP-3051 can only be prevented by removal of 80% data expunged. Addendum 3051. On 2000, Foundation personnel used a remote-controlled device to extract a sample of SCP-305's rock structure. SCP-305 began to emit loud grinding noises and a low growling sound. Existing cracks in the rock formation deepened, and several new ones formed in the vicinity of the removed rock sample. SCP-305 then moved its arms upward slightly and slid 1 foot, about 10 centimeters, across the ground as if taking a step, shedding rock fragments as it moved before returning to its stationary state. Following this event, the range of SCP-305's psychic influence tripled, resulting in several data expunged. Sample proved to be ordinary sedimentary rock, consistent with the surrounding area. Follow-up X-ray scans of the formation itself reveal the presence of suggesting that the rock formation may actually be an imprisoned instance of data expunged. Upgrade to Keter requested. Pending. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-304, The Signal, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.